Okay, in this video, you will learn how to represent functions, including piecewise functions in two real-life situations. And this is our lesson one in general mathematics, and it is called functions. Okay? So here is our lesson outline. Number one, you're going to learn the definitions of function and relations. Second is we're going to test if a given graph is a function or not using the vertical line test. And then the last is the representation of these functions into real life situations, functions including the piecewise functions. So let's start with the first outline. We have the definition of relation. What is relation? It says it is a rule that relates values from a set of values. This first set of values is called the domain, and to a second set of values called the range. So, dalawa yung values natin tinutukoy dito. Yung isa ay domain, yung isa ay range. So, there is relationship between these two set of values. Okay? At ang tawag natin doon is a relation. There exists a correspondence between these two sets. Okay? Now, how do we define the correspondence of these two values? It can be defined by a table, an equation, or a graph. Okay? Para malaman natin na talagang may correspondence ang dalawang variables. Okay? So, paano i-define? It can be defined the correspondence using table, equation, and graph. Okay? And, of course, this relation is a set of ordered pairs, x, y. Okay? Yung x natin is the domain, yung y natin, yun yung range. Okay? So, pag may correspondence yung dalawa, we can write this into an ordered pair. Okay? Now, magbibigay ako ng halimbawa kung paano yung correspondence by a table. Okay? Halimbawa, we have here a table that defines correspondence between a set of percent scores and a set of letter grades. Ibig sabihin ito, if your score is between 80, sorry, this is wrong, it should be 80 to 100. Okay? If your score is between 80 to 90, this is 90 as I said, there is a mistake, a typo error. Your equivalent grade is B. While if your grade lies somewhere from 90 to 100, the equivalent grade is A. So, ano yung correspondence doon? So, there is a correspondence between the score in percent to the equivalent grade of the student natin. Okay? Halimbawa, 94 ang grade mo, it corresponds to A. Yeah? It corresponds to letter A. Kasi yung score niya lies between 90 to 100. Using ordered pair notation, we record this correspondence as 94, A. So, there is a relationship between the two. Okay? The relationship is for your grade of 94%, it corresponds to the grade A using this table. Okay? So, meron siyang tinatawag na relation. So, the second example of defining the correspondence between two variables is by an equation. Okay? Paano? Okay, sorry. Let's see equation natin. Let's say the equation is D equals 16T squared. Ano yung relation nung D dun sa T? So, ibig sabihin, yung ating pong distance D indicates the distance travel of a falling object which corresponds to the time T that it has been falling. Ibig sabihin po, if we're going to neglect a resistance, this is about freely falling body, as t increases, d increases also. So if t equals 0, from my example here, it corresponds to a distance traveled by an object falling vertical to a zero distance. Because if you substitute 0 to this equation, d equals 0 also. So the relationship of these two is 0-0 in an ordered pair. Okay? Ano yung ating first variable, t, and the second variable is d. So the relationship or the correspondence between the two is 0-0. But if t equals 1, it corresponds to a distance of 16. So one squared times 16 is 16. So therefore, the distance traveled of this object falling downward is equal to 16. Okay, so we have an ordered pair of 1, 16. So if we're going to come up with, if we're going to assign values of t to this equation, there is always an equivalent distance d. Okay, so yung set of values nung ating first value, yung nasa, yung tatawag nating abscisa in xy plane, at tatawagin natin siyang domain. Okay? At lahat ng ating y values here, yung 0 and then 16, tinatawag natin range. Okay? So, yan ang aking example about the definition of correspondence between variables using table and using by an equation. Now, ano naman yung function? Actually, function is just a subset of relation. Meaning, function is also a relation where each element in the domain is related to only one value in the range by some rule. So, ibig sabihin, kapag magiging function lamang ang relation, kapag we have one domain that is equivalent to one range only. So, hindi pwedeng isang domain, maraming equivalent na range or y values. Okay? Ibig sabihin nun, no two ordered pairs have the same first coordinate and different second coordinate. So, dapat, kung ang x natin is a domain, dapat ang domain natin, kung yung bawat domain has an equivalent 1 only to the range or y value. So, hindi pwedeng dalawang ordered pairs, isang first coordinate, yung x natin, may equivalent na 2 or more second coordinate. Hindi pwede yon. Kapag merong x values tayo na may mahigit na equivalent na values, mahigit sa dalawa na equivalent na values sa y, that is not anymore a function. Pero siya pa rin ay relation. Okay? Halimbawa, which of the following relations are functions? Okay. So, pag-aralan natin na isa-isa. We have number, yung una, yung function f. Ang set of ordered pairs niya ay 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 5, 4, 7. So, ano nakikita natin doon? Examine natin yung mga x values niya. So, mapapansin natin, bawat isang x values lamang, walang magkaparehas na x values sa set of ordered pairs natin. Okay? So, analyze natin yung first example. Yung mga domain natin, you have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yun yung ating domain, yung x values. Ang equivalent niya sa ating y values ay 2, 3, 5, and 7. So, bawat isang domain has only equivalent one value to our range. So, ang relationship nila is 1 to 1. Okay? 1 to 1. One value of x, equivalent niya, isang value rin sa y. So, this is a function. Okay? A 1 to 1 correspondence is ating pong set of ordered pairs is a function. How about the second function g? We have the set of ordered pairs. Gagawin natin ay 1, 1, 2, 3. Okay. May dalawa tayong 1 values na may equivalent na dalawang y values na ating range. There is a mistake with my illustration. Dapat wala na itong isang 1 na to. Okay. So, mapapansin nyo, yung 1 natin, which is the domain or x value, has an equivalent na dalawang y values o dalawang range. Okay? Yung 2 natin, ganun din, isang x value, may equivalent na dalawang second coordinate. Yung first coordinate, may equivalent na dalawa sa second coordinate. Anong ibig sabihin nun? This is not a function. Hindi siya magiging function kapag meron tayong isang x-coordinate na may dalawang equivalent na y-coordinate. This is not a function, and this function is, this relation is one-to-many. Okay? And one-to-many type of function is not, one-to-many type of relation is not a function. Okay? The third example, you have 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 9, 4, 8. Okay. Ang domain natin ay 1, 2, 3, and 4. While our range, ito, 6, 8, 9. Yung ating dalawang domains dito, dalawang x values natin dito, correspond to one value of y. Okay? So, this is many x values equivalent to 1 y value. So, this is also a function. Many to 1 ang tawag natin sa correspondence dito sa given nating set of ordered pairs. And many to 1 relation is a function also. Okay? Palitan natin. 1 to 1 is a function. 1, many to 1 is also a function, but 1 to many is not a function. Okay. Pero yung mga yon, relations pa rin. Okay. Ito naman, by mapping diagrams, tingnan natin yung representation niya kung siya yung functions. Number 1, we have domain A, B, C. A related to x, b is related to y, at the same time c is related to y. So ito 1 to 1, ito itong first set, itong dalawang sets na to, by, cy, is many x values equivalent to 1 y value. Therefore, this is an example of a function. Many to 1. Okay? Another example. We have x related to A, x related to B, y, I forgot, meron pa dapat itong C. Sorry. So, ibig sabihin nito, one value of x is related to two values of y or range. So therefore, this is 1 to many. 1 to many is not a function. Okay? Remember, yung ating domain, yun yung ating, tawag natin dito, independent variable. Okay? Yung y natin, yung ating, yung range natin, yun yung dependent variable, yung mga y values. Okay? Another example. Jana is related to Ray, Maya is related to Ken, Donna is related to Mark. So we have here 1-to-1 relationship. So this is a function. Okay? Okay, you already know how to determine if the given set of ordered pairs is a function. And you already know that if a given mapping diagrams is also a function. That is, by understanding the maps and by understanding the given set of ordered pairs, if the given set of ordered pairs of math corresponds to one-to-one, one-to-many, or many-to-one relationships. Okay? Now, we have the vertical line of vertical line test. There is another way for us to determine if a given function, if a given relation is a function based from the graph by passing the what we call vertical line test, and should intersect only to one point on the given graph of the function or relation. Pag nag-intersect siya sa isang point lamang sa ating curve, then the given relation is a function, or the graph is a graph of a function. Okay? Halimbawa, we have here a function. So, magpapas lang tayo ng vertical line kahit saan part na yan. Dapat sa lahat pala ng parts. Ano? Let's say, daan natin yung vertical line diyan. Tumama lang siya dun sa isang point ng ating graph. Nung ating ito. So, therefore, this is a function. Kasi tumama lang siya sa isang point sa ating curve. Okay? Another example. We have here a parabola opens upward. And when we pass a vertical line dito sa ating parabola, mag-i-intersect lang siya sa isang point, sa curve, kahit saan mo idaan dyan yung vertical line. So therefore, this graph is a graph of a function. Another example. We have here a straight line. So magpapas tayo ng vertical line. So kahit saan mo idaan yung ating vertical line, it will only intersect one point on our graph of a straight line. Therefore, this graph is a graph of a function. Because this is called the linear function. Another example. Yan. How about, this is an ellipse. Okay? Ellipse siya. Magpas tayo ng vertical line. Oops! Tumama siya sa dalawang points. So, ibig sabihin, this graph is a graph, is not a graph of a function. Kasi nag-intersect siya yung ating vertical line sa dalawang points dun sa ating graph. So, this is not a function. Last example. This is a hyperbola. Okay? So, pag nagpass tayo ng vertical line sa ating xy plane, mapapansin nyo mag-i-intersect yung ating vertical line sa dalawang points ng ating graph. So, therefore, this graph is not a function. Okay. So, I'm going to give you activity sheet number 1. And based from my lesson, our lesson, you're going to answer activity sheet number 1. I will be uploading or post it on our Google Classroom. Thank you. Goodbye.